Today at shopdap.com, we talk about superchargers versus turbochargers. When you say the word supercharge or turbocharge to a regular person, they may not know why it's good, but they know it's good. The words are so synonymous with more power that they're being used on cars that don't even have turbos or engines. Whether you're looking to buy a car that already has one or looking to upgrade your naturally aspirated engine, the age-old question remains, which one is better? A normal engine has four strokes: suck, squeeze, bang, and blow. While these sound like your late-night internet history search, they actually are instructive to tell you how an engine works. First, you suck the air into the engine, then the piston comes back up and squeezes the air-fuel mixture. Then your spark plug ignites the mixture and bang, your piston is sent down, only to return back up to blow out the spent exhaust gases. To get more power out of your engine, you need more air and fuel to make a bigger bang. Superchargers and turbochargers both operate under the same principle, which is force more air in to make a bigger bang. The difference is how they accomplish it. A turbocharger uses a shaft with two spinny wheels attached to it. These spinny wheels are separated by the hot and cold side of the turbo. The hot side of the turbo is attached to the exhaust, and the cold side of the turbo is attached to the intake. The turbo uses spent exhaust gases coming out of the engine to spin the turbine of the turbo, which allows it to force more air into the engine. A supercharger in our case uses two twisty shafts that are attached to a pulley. That pulley is belt driven and spins the two twisty shafts together, forcing more air into the engine. Let's talk about advantages and disadvantages. Turbos are more efficient. This is because they use exhaust gases, which are a byproduct of the combustion process in an engine, to drive them. The downside of this is that the power is not instant due to what's known as turbo lag. Turbos take time to spool. This is because the exhaust gases coming out of the engine are not going fast enough at low engine RPMs. The advantages of the turbo are that it is more efficient, which also means has more power potential, but the downside is that it takes more time to make power. Also, they make cool noises. Superchargers have instant power. The second you mash your foot to the floor, it's time to go. But that immediate response comes at a cost, which is efficiency. Since superchargers are belt driven, they rob horsepower from the engine to allow you to turn this pulley. And while a supercharger is a giver, it's a giver and a taker. They also make cool noises. When it comes to upgrading a naturally aspirated engine with one of these, there's a pretty clear choice. Turbos are used on more production vehicles, are generally easier to retrofit, and have more power potential. While superchargers are used on less production vehicles, are more complicated to retrofit to a vehicle, and since they're less efficient, have less total power potential. This gives turbos the edge in both ease of installation, cost, and power potential. When it comes to buying a car with one of these, it's really up to you. The advantages of a turbo over a supercharger on a production vehicle are not going to be something that would make me select a turbo vehicle over a supercharger vehicle or a supercharged vehicle over a turbo vehicle. And because the number of choices for supercharged cars are so limited, it would not make me shy away from a car that has a supercharger. But most likely you're gonna end up with a turbo car. Since there aren't that many supercharged cars on the market, we have an all-track with a 1.8 liter turbo engine and an S4 with a 3 liter supercharged engine. They both have awesome advantages to them, but my advice would be test drive some, see how you like them. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more like it.